That warm introduction. Good morning, students. I hope you all are able to hear my voice clearly and see the screen which I have shared just now. So before I begin the session, I want the session to be more interactive. And if you have any questions on the today's subject, so please feel free to ask them in the chat window, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions at the end of the day. So with that, we'll get started our session. So in today's session, we'll be seeing about how drones and extended reality will be used in Industry 4.0. So as we all know, everyone is talking about moving to Industry 4.0 for things like automation or other technologies like Internet of Things, 3D printer, drones, extended reality, and so on. So though there are many technologies which will be helpful in moving towards Industry 4.0, I'll be focusing on how these two technologies such as drones and extended reality will be helpful for industries such as education, healthcare, manufacturing, or any industry for that matter. How these two technologies will be useful, we'll be seeing that. So I'll be explaining about the basics and also share some videos of what I have done in both virtual and augmented reality. And towards the end, we'll have some Q&A as well. So first we'll talk about drones, then we'll go about the extended reality part. So drone, as we all know, is an unmanned aerial vehicle or unmanned aerial aircraft system, which it is called as. And it's a flying robot which can be remotely controlled through software controlled flight plans in their Embraer system. So this is the basic definition of what a drone is about. Of course, we all would have been knowing what a drone or what the definition is all about it. So now we'll see what are the different types of drones before we see how it can be used in Industry 4.0. So these are the different types of drones which is categorized by our Indian government. So first is nano drone is which is less than or equal to 250 grams is known as nano drones. And the next is micro drone is from 250 gram to 2 kgs is categorized as micro, and small is still 25 kg, medium from 25 to 150, and large greater than 150 kgs. So these are the different types of drones categorized for different purposes. So this medium and large drones will be used for lifting heavy objects, for transporting heavy objects via drones. So for that, these medium and large drones are used. But whatever the things which we see are basically micro drones. So micro to small, not even small, micro drones, what we have seen in marriage halls and in other places, you'd be seeing basically micro and small types of drones. And coming to the nano drones, which is less than or equal to 250 grams. So these are very tiny drones. With these drones, we can just fly and get some data out of it. But the problem with nano drone is if there is a heavy wind blowing when you are flying the drone, your nano drone also will go away along with that wind. So that is why nano drones are not much useful and not harmful also. So these are the different types of drones which one should be aware of. Madam, is my screen visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Visible only.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So now we'll see how these drones can be used in Industry 4.0 and extensively in all these areas which I have listed. So first is on the mining and construction side. Mining and construction side, using this LIDAR. LIDAR is a light detection and ranging sensors added to the drone. With that, they'll be able to take the stockpile of that mining area. For example, there's a huge mining thing is there. Before drones were there, people will manually go and check how much stockpile is there, how much thing is left in that place. Manually, they have to check. So that is a tedious and time-consuming process. But after the advent of drones and added to the LIDAR scanner, so once you fly that drone in that mining field, you'll be able to measure the exact stockpile of whatever the minerals or anything is available in that place precisely, and get that data immediately as well. So in that areas, drones are already used and will be used more in the coming months and years as well. And second thing is on for solar panels and oil fields inspections, for inspecting this huge solar panels placed in the land. So what the problem with solar panels is, so after you install the solar panels, if there are any issue, any minor issue in the any one of the cell in the solar panel, that issue will replicate to other cells and it will hugely impact the power produced out of solar panel. For that, every 3 months or every now and then, the solar panel inspection used to happen. So previously, solar panel inspection manually, people will check with the infrared scanners in their hand to make sure all that solar panel is working perfectly. But again, it's a more time consuming process. But with the drones, it has become very easy for solar panel inspection. For example, once you have that infrared camera fitted in the drone and flew it above the solar panel, what the drone with the infrared camera does is, so if there is any problem or any defect in the solar cell, that alone will be reflected as a hotspot in the data. So for example, if there is a few cells are damaged in the solar panel, that will be mentioned in some other color, red color or any other color, to identify that particular solar panel cell is damaged. So by getting this data, so people will rectify that cells and make sure none of the solar panels are affected due to that. So this saves a huge money for them in solar panel inspection. Same for oil fields inspection or windmill inspection. So for all these things, nowadays drones are used effectively. And coming to the other thing, surveillance. Surveillance, as we all know, previously, if any a political leader or for any other thing happening, so there will be huge surveillance and things going on. Now, air surveillance is also possible with the drones. So they are doing more air surveillance with drone and make sure there is no problem in that particular confined space where that particular meeting or that particular thing is happening. So for surveillance also, it is used to move. And the next thing is for 3D mapping. So 3D mapping is one of the biggest area where a drone can be used. So how this 3D mapping works is, for example, for surveying the land. So previously, surveyors used to go to the land and survey it effectively, how much land is there for constructing the road or for any other purpose. The government may be looking for the data of that particular land. The same thing, we can be doing it with the drones. So how it can run is, once the drone flies over a particular area, it will collect that images of that particular area, and that images will be converted into a 3D mapping data. So with that, the 3D mapping data, government or the companies which is going to work on that will be able to get more information about it. So this is one example, not just surveying, just for seeing how much water is there in that area, or how much vegetation is going on in that area. So for all these things, with the 3D mapping, we'll be able to get the accurate data. As you could see from the current image in the slide, you could see there are green patches are there, and as well as some other hotspots given in another colors there. So this could be like, for vegetation, we can check. For example, the green ones are the not affected ones. The red ones are the affected ones. So with that, 3D mapping data, people will be able to take decision on the affected region alone. So this way, in getting 3D mapping, and from that 3D mapping to develop that application or that area further, drones is used more. And we'll also see a video shortly of how it can be, how it is done. And the next thing is for delivery. So delivering drones for delivery will be coming in the near future. Just like how we order food in Swiggy and Zomato, so people come to come and give the food at our doorsteps. Same way, drones will be used for delivering not for the foods initially, but for emergency medical supplies and for last mile connectivity where transportation is not possible. So at that point of time or at that places, drones can be used effectively. So even US government has initiated last mile medical supplies delivery via drones. So there are companies like UPS in the US, which is using drones to supply this emergency medical supplies. So just imagine if someone is looking for an emergency medical supply, and with the current transportation we have, it will take time, and it also it has to reach on time for the people who wants it. But with drones, that traffic issue is not there, and it can reach on time without any issues. So first, the drones, they are trying for emergency medical supplies, and slowly we will see that being adopted for delivering normal e-commerce items or whatever the food items via drones also will be possible in the near future. Even our Indian government has envisaged to use drones for hospital to hospital organ transplantation. So as we all know, transporting an organ or transporting emergency medical supply from one hospital to another hospital is a tedious process due to the traffic and other issues we have. So government is planning to have drone hotspots between hospital to hospital. For example, any organ or any medical supply is needed from one hospital to the other one, easily they can transport that organ or the medical supply effectively via drones. So we'll see that in the near future, how in healthcare also the drones will be used more. And the next thing is in agricopters are spray drones. So this one is the spraying drones, which during COVID-19 pandemic also we have seen in Chennai and other places. For spraying disinfectant, they have been using this sprayer drones. So the sprayer drones are first designed for agriculture purpose only. So for spraying pesticide and insecticides. So there farmers and agriculturists are started using this agricopters or sprayer drones. So advantage out of it is within minutes, it can spray a huge area of land and without any human intervention. So there is no manual labor needed. Which, if that farmer has, within few days, he can learn how to operate these types of drones. And then he himself can spray pesticides or insecticides to his land without any